Ready! Present!
In the U.S., there have been over 100 duels. Only few have ended with the two men who had decided to duel, resolving the problem and not firing their weapon. Dueling is a big and important part of U.S. history. Dueling was part of the fabric of early American culture. It brought short-lived triumph to the victor, but long-term tragedy to the victim, leading to death of brilliant men such as Alexander Hamilton and his son, Philip Hamilton, who could have accomplished more. Ultimately, it symbolizes an inability to resolve problems and find solutions through compromise. Dueling dates back to ancient Greece and Rome. They used weapons such as sledgehammers, maces, and chains. In ancient Rome, men used nets and trients as weapons in their duels and only had a shoulder pad as protection. The 15th century dueling took the form of jousting. Later on, toward the end of the 18th and 19th century, dueling became illegal. But many of the men involved were pardoned when they were in court because both men had agreed to the challenge. In 1859, after the last duel was fought in America, 18 states had officially outlawed duels. In the 18th century, duels were very common in America and Great Britain. Many famous people have fought in duels. Although women didn't have the same equal rights as men, they did duel. In 1792, Lady Almeria Braddock had invited Miss Elphinstone to her home in Britain for a cup of tea, and the meeting spun out of hand when Miss Elphinstone made a casual comment on Lady Almeria Braddock's age. Lady Almeria Braddock got quite angry about that and challenged Miss Elphinstone to a duel with not only guns but swords as well. Both made it out alive, and in the end, Miss Elphinstone wrote an apology letter. Andrew Jackson, who became the 7th president, fought in 103 duels, but his most famous duel was between him and Charles Dickinson, who died as a result. Dickinson was angry at Jackson, and so insulted Jackson's wife. Soon after, Jackson challenged Dickinson to the duel. During the duel, Dickinson fired first and shot Jackson near the rib, and they later found out that the bullet was millimeters from his heart. Jackson calmly put his hand over the wound and took his time aiming at his target. He fired, but he missed, which should have ended the duel. But Jackson recocked his pistol and fired, this time fatally wounding him. 3 years before the Hamilton and Byrd duel, Hamilton's son, Philip Hamilton, fought in a duel. Philip Hamilton had heard George Eaker insulting his father, Alexander Hamilton, at a 4th of July speech accusing him of being willing to overthrow Thomas Jefferson's presidency by force. In the speech, Eaker accused Hamilton of misusing his position as Inspector General during the Adams administration to intimidate his political enemies. Later, Philip and a friend confronted Eaker and challenged him to a duel because he refused to apologize about the topic. The Broadway hit Hamilton has made the duel between Alexander Hamilton and Aaron Burr in 1804 most famous of all duels. The duel was initiated because Hamilton had made multiple attacks damaging Burr's reputation. He had said things such as this: "After a remarkable 35 tie votes, a small group of Federalists changing sides and voted in Jefferson's favor." Alexander Hamilton, who had supported Jefferson as the lesser of two evils, was instrumental in breaking the deadlock. Burr soon heard the criticism and challenged Hamilton to a duel. Even Abraham Lincoln fought in a duel. As a young lawyer in 1842, he was challenged to a duel with swords by James Shields. They fought at a place in Missouri, ironically called Bloody Island. Bloody Island is now a recreational area. Thankfully, Lincoln decided to use his height to his advantage and cut a tree branch that was above him and frightened Shields. So before it started, it ended with the rivals making a truce. It is tragic that men with brilliant legal minds such as Alexander Hamilton and potentially his son, Philip, died in these tragic attempts to preserve their honor. However, the affair of honor was a dangerous game for more reasons than imminent death. said Jarrett Stepman, the author of the article America's Five Most Legendary Duels, and speaking of Alexander Hamilton. The feeling of the whole community were agonized beyond description, according to Oliver Wolcott, Jr., who served as Washington's Secretary of Treasury after Hamilton resigned. The community in New York was distraught after Hamilton was shot in the duel. Judith St. George, the author of the book The Duel, explained that the triumph of dueling was honor. Duels were common among the military officers as a badge of courage and leadership. General Alexander Hamilton and Colonel Aaron Burr were both military men. Hamilton had been involved in 6 duels as a challenger or as a second, but had never actually dueled. Even knowing what terrible pain the dueling of his son had caused the family, accepted Burr's challenge. People put their whole life on the line for one thing that they most likely knew had a strong chance of not ending well. Empires rise and fall, and so do the people who built them. Hamilton came from so little to make so much, winning a war, creating a constitution, establishing a financial system, before he became involved in scandal and despair, said John Sedgwick, the author of the book The War of Two. Dueling rarely ended well. These men put their whole life on the line for one thing that they probably knew wouldn't end well. This battle played out in an unexpected form in our social media age. Dueling letters containing all of the formality and idiosyncrasies that you might expect. Today, our leaders in the federal government duel with words, and their reputation and honor is usually at stake. In 2019, the government was in its first real feud between Nancy Pelosi and President Trump. The government had been shut down due to the disagreement about funding a wall on the U.S.-Mexican border. After inviting President Trump to give his State of the Union address, Representative Pelosi uninvited him, citing the shutdown, which was more than a month old. In the end, the State of the Union was postponed, and the duel ended when the government shutdown ended on January 30th. Dueling was part of the fabric of early American culture. It brought little amount of triumph to the winner or the victor of the duel, and long-term tragedy to the victim, leading to death of sometimes brilliant men, such as Alexander Hamilton and his son, Philip Hamilton, who could have accomplished so much more. Ultimately, it shows the inability to resolve problems and make a compromise. Although lots of people risked their lives defending their country, duels were to protect a man's honor. It may have been more important to someone to protect their honor, but with their life, today that seems a bit absurd.